हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ प्लांट पैथोलॉजी, केडीएसपी एग्रीकल्चर कॉलेज नासिक। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड सनफ्लावर रस्ट, इट्स कॉजल ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड इट्स मैनेजमेंट। नाउ टुडे वी विल सी द नेक्स्ट डिसीज ऑफ सनफ्लावर, दैट इज अल्टरनेरिया लीफ ब्लाइट। अल्टरनेरिया लीफ ब्लाइट ऑफ सनफ्लावर कॉज्ड ड्यू टू अल्टरनेरिया हेलियंथी। दिस इज वन ऑफ द फंगल पैथोजन एंड most economic and most destructive disease. It occurs on all the varieties of sunflower in winter season and it spread rapidly during the rainy season. The disease has been reported to reduce the seed yield by 27 to 80% of total yield and also reduced oil yield by 17 to 35%. So you can judge the importance of this alternative leaf blight of sunflower. This disease also affect the quality of seeds, which adversely affect seed germination and vigor of seedlings. If you see the symptoms of this alternative leaf blight, you can found that the fungus produces brown spot on leaves, but the spots can also be seen on stem, sepals and petals. As you can see in image, there is the brownish color spots that develop on leaves and all over the plant parts it can be found. The lesions on the leaves are dark brown to black, circular to oval spots ranging from 0.2 to 0.5 millimeter in diameter. The spots in latter phase it enlarges in size and it produces concentric rings inside the spots and become irregular in shape. So this is one of the important character of this alternaria leaf blight, that is the concentric rings were produced inside the spot and all the spots become irregular in shape. This is the marks of identification of alternaria leaf blight. The spots are often surrounded by a chlorotic zone with necrotic center. Under high atmospheric humidity, several spots coalesce to show bigger irregular lesions and form big patches, leading to the drying and defoliation of leaves. The disease sometimes causes rotting of flower heads and affects the quality of seeds by reducing the germination percentage. Similarly, if there is severe rotting of head, such rotted head should be fallen down on the soil so that ill contributing character of this sunflower crop is directly destroyed by this fungal pathogen. Fungus produces cylindrical conidiophores, which are pale grey to yellow colored, straight or curved, simple or branched, or it may be septate and bear single conidium. These are some microscopic characters of this fungi. Conidia of this alternaria are cylindrical to long ellipsoid, and the most important character of this conidia is 2 to 5 septate with transverse and longitudinal septa. These are some marks of identification for alternaria spores. If you see the disease cycle of this alternaria leaf blight, you will found that the primary source of infection of this alternaria blight is by infected mycelium or infected host tissues or weed host, which serves as a primary source of infection. This fungus is also found seed-borne and secondary source of infection by wind-borne conidia, which may travel from infected portion to the healthy portion through air currents. In favorable conditions, rainy weather, cool winter climate and late sown crops are most favorable to attack of this alternaria leaf blight. So this is all about symptoms and favorable conditions of this alternaria leaf blight. Now for management of this alternaria blight, we have to apply all integrated control management practices. In that, we can grow tolerant varieties like PSH1, which is found tolerant against this alternaria leaf blight. Similarly, all infected plant debris should be kept outside the field to reduce the inertial inoculum of this alternaria. Actually, all the weed host which are part of this alternaria outside the field. In early season, infection of this crop, as we have seen, this aged crop and crops. The next important point is optimum spacing should be maintained, that is 60 by 30 centimeter or 45 by 35 are helpful for reducing the. Similarly, seed treatment should be tolerated of 2 gram per kg for management of this alternative. The disease emergence occurs after the planting, then you can also control it by spraying with fungicides like carbendazim or propiconazole or terbinafine at the rate of 2 gram per kg. So this is all about management of alternaria leaf blight. In next lecture we will see sclerotial wilt or collar rot or Sclerotinia stem rot of sunflower and its management. Thanks for watching this video.